Hi, Mr. Snyder here. This is for everybody in class or at home today, cycle three. What I have here is a pendulum, and you know, they swing back and forth. And we're going to do a little graphing exercise today. You're going to do two different graphs for me, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to time the period of a pendulum, and that symbol is T. Okay, and then we're going to, the period is from there all the way back to there, a complete oscillation, or the period of a pendulum. And we're going to measure the time it takes for it to swing at 2 meters. Then we'll put it up at 1.5 meters, 1 meter, half a meter, and 1/4 of a meter. Okay. And we'll go ahead and we'll record, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let it swing 10 times so I can cut my error in timing down by 10. So I'll time how long it takes for 10 complete periods, and then we'll just divide it by 10 to get what one period is, and then we'll square it, because what you're going to do, and you're going to graph period versus length, so 1/4, half, 1, 1.5, and 2 meters, and then you're going to figure out what the square of the period is, and you're going to graph period squared by the length. You're going to plot the points, you're going to draw best fit line, find the slope, and give me the equation of the line with the units on that slope. So let's get some data collected here. Like I said, I'm gonna let this swing 10 times, and we'll go from there, one, hope I don't lose count, two, three, yes, sometimes data collection is tedious, four, especially when you have to watch somebody else do it, five, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So that was 29.5 seconds. So for a 2 meter pendulum length, 10 swings was 29.5 seconds. So one complete swing was just a tenth of that, or 2.9 seconds, and we'll go ahead and figure out what the square of that is. 8.7 seconds. Okay. So from now on, I'll time them. I'll do the 10 swings. You go ahead and calculate what 1/10 of that is, and then what the square is, and then do the graphing. But let me move this up to the 1.5 meter mark. String out of the way. This little clip to hold the string. So let's get this swinging here. Hold on. 1, 2. You might notice it's going a little faster. As you shorten the pendulum, it takes less time to swing back and forth. 6, hope I haven't missed the count again, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that was 25.7 seconds. So you figure out what 1/10 of that is, and then what the square of that is. And I will go ahead and move the pendulum up to a 1 meter length, so 1 meter from the ceiling. And again, let me get the string out of the way. Or not. Okay. You notice this should take even less time. Let me give it a swing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's 21.3. Get ahead with that. 1.3, you notice it takes less and less time as you shorten the pendulum. Okay. Now we'll move it up to where it's a half a meter length. Swing. Hope that's still on the screen. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. So whatever error I had in starting and stopping the stopwatch, I'm dividing that error by 10 because it was only the one error, but it was 10 swings. So that's 15.6. Okay, go to negative 10th and then find the square. And undo that. We'll move it up to the last length, which is only a quarter of a meter. Hope you can see the pendulum bobbing around there. Only going to do this video once. Errors or not? Okay. A little swing. 11.6 seconds. Okay, so we've gone from 2.95 seconds for a complete swing down to just 1.1, so a little over a third of the original time. So your job now is to take this data and do those two graphs. Best fit line. Yes, equation of the line with the slope and with its units, and then make sure you submit that. Thank you.